Hello everyone. In this video, we will see how to use the basic elements and triggers blocks in FLProg with the ESP32 NodeMCU board. Let's start by creating a new project with the ESP32 controller using the function block diagram. The ESP32 WROOM Dev Kit V1 by Expressive is what is here. I have the ESP32 WROOM NodeMCU. They both share the same features, but with different pinouts and markings. And why the Dev Kit GPIO pin numbering starts with D, the NodeMCU begins with P. The notable features of the board are 32-bit dual microprocessor with inbuilt Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, USB bridge, and processor frequency of 160 to 340 MHz. Check out the details of the ESP32 features and pins from the description and pins tabs. I will use the circuit connection shown here to test the basic elements and triggers blocks. Connect three push-button switches to pins 12, 14, and 15 of the board. An LED to pin 13 through a 220 ohms resistor. My NodeMCU has the CH320 USB chip, so you need to download and install the device driver from the link in the description. Again, before we move on, you must also install the ESP32 board in Arduino IDE. Copy this link from the description and paste it into the Additional Board Manager field in Preferences. Go to Boards Manager and search for ESP32, then install. Going back to FLProg, select the input tags and add an input with the name Switch 1, digital type, and pin D12. Select Enable Pull-up Resistor. Then click OK. Add two other digital inputs, switch 2 and switch 3, at pin D14 and D15 with pull-up resistors enabled. Select and add a digital output with the name of LED at pin D13. Leave the initial state at off. The status not used is displayed by the variables. You can always double-click on the variables to edit the parameters. Now drag an OR block from the Basic Elements Blocks library into the program. You can also add blocks to the program by right-clicking and selecting Insert a New Block. Double-click on the OR block in the OR block library window to display its information. The OR block output queue is on when either or both inputs are on. To add more inputs to the block, right-click on it and select Add Input. Drag switch 1, switch 2, and switch 3 inputs into the program. Also, drag in the LED output. Observe that the status not used is no more by these variables. Draw connections from the switches to the inputs of the OR block and from the output to the LED. Then click on the Compile Project icon from the main menu. This will open the Arduino IDE. Ensure that the ESP32 and the connected serial port number are selected from the Tools menu. Then click on Upload. Close the IDE when done uploading to return to FLProg. Observe that the LED connected to the board is already on and will not go off when any or all the switches are pressed. This is because of the internal pull-up resistors that make the inputs high. To reverse the input state of the switches, right-click on their output and select Invert. Then upload the code again. The LED is now off and comes on when any or all the switches are pressed. Right-click on and remove the OR block. Double-click on the AND block in the block library window. The output queue of the AND block will only be on when all its inputs are on. drag the block into the program and add another input. Then draw connections between the switches, the block, and the LED. When the code is uploaded to the board, observe that the LED will only come on when all switches are pressed. A bounce block delays the logic status of contacts for 40 milliseconds to protect it against false pulse. It should be placed after digital inputs. Protection from bounce is also enabled when inputs are configured. The exclusive OR block output will be on when any one of the inputs is on, otherwise it will be off, as can be seen when uploaded into the board. You can design a custom combination logic with the state table block. Drag a state table into the program and double-click on it. Increase the number of inputs to 3. Click on Add and on the 0 below I2 to change it to 1. Add a second row and change the I1 and I2 states to 1. Add the last row and change the I1 and I3 states to 1. When the code is uploaded to the board, the LED comes on only when switch 2 is pressed, or when switch 1 and switch 2 are pressed, or when switch 1 and switch 3 are pressed. Otherwise, it will remain off. The terminal block is used to connect the program boards. Click on the Add Board icon on the program window. You can double-click on the board to name it and add a description. Delete the LED from board 1 and drag in a terminal block. Double-click on the terminal block and name it T1. Drag the LED to board 2 and right-click on its input. Select to connect to the terminal. Then select T1 and click OK. The same response is observed when the LED was in board 1. This can also be used to connect more outputs. The triggers blocks are set reset, T trigger, rising and falling edge triggers. The set reset block is used to turn on and off an output with the set and reset input. Delete switch 3 and the state table block. Drag an SRO block into the program. Connect the inputs and outputs to the SRO block. Switch 1 will turn on the LED, while switch 2 will turn it off. ROS block functions like the SRO block. The T trigger block changes its output state on a rising edge of its input. Delete the SRO block and switch 2. Insert the T trigger block and connect switch 1 and the LED to it. Observe that when the push button switch is pressed, the LED is turned on and goes off when the switch is pressed again. The rising edge trigger outputs a momentary pulse when the rising edge of a signal is detected by its input, while the falling edge trigger outputs a momentary pulse when the falling edge of a signal is detected by its input. Thanks for watching. I hope you find this video helpful. Hope to see you soon.